The next part is fixed appliances. Now, it's not small appliances. Small appliances are cord and plug connected things all throughout the house that the engineer or the electrician doesn't have any idea really of what those loads are going to be. Fixed appliances are generally appliances that are going to be included on the prints. Things like water heaters, blower motors, garbage disposals, things that are fixed in place and probably, I say probably, have a dedicated circuit. Okay? So if you look at Article 220.53, it says, it shall be permissible to apply a demand factor of 75% to the nameplate rating load of four or more appliances fastened in place. So we're not talking about stuff that gets plugged in and moved around the house. All right? So if you look back at the stats in the handouts from the beginning of this presentation, you'll see that this house has five fixed appliances that we need to concern ourselves with. You have a water heater, dishwasher, trash compactor, garbage disposal, and a blower motor. Okay? That's five. So the code book says if you have four or more, you can apply a demand factor of 75%. That should make some sense. The more loads there are, the less likely it will be that they are all on at the same time. Okay? So because we have five of them, we can take a total of the nameplate ratings, add it all up, and we can multiply that total, in this case it's 11,000 volt amps, by 0.75 or 75%. So our fixed appliances allowance comes out to 8,250 volt amps. That's the second part. Again, we're going to put that number off to the side on a column. We're going to keep a running tally.
Fixed appliance loads have to be accounted for in the standard calculation. Now on this worksheet, some of the common ones are listed for you. Dishwasher, disposer, compactor, water heater. Of course there's going to be other loads, and in the real world you'd have to check the blueprints and hunt and peck and find out exactly what's going to be installed in the house as a fixed appliance. Now, in our practice problem, we were given a list of the stats for the dwelling unit. And conveniently enough, the fixed appliances were all kind of grouped together on that list. In a test situation, if they want you to perform the calculation for fixed appliances, they have to tell you what those appliances are. And they really can't avoid basically listing them for you, so that makes our life a little easier, at least in a testing situation. So what we have to do is transfer these numbers from this list to the worksheet so that we can apply our demand factor. So we start with 6,000 watts on the water heater. So put 6,000 here. And for the purposes of these calculations, watts, volt amps, they're really the same thing. In the real world, they're not the same thing, but for these calculations, they are. So the water heater's taken care of. Dishwasher is 1300 volt amps. So we enter that here. Trash compactor, 900 watts. Garbage disposer is 1300 volt amps. And then finally, there's a blower motor installed in this house. And it is 1500 watts. Now that's not on our list already, so we'll have to put that in there. Right. So blower motors taken care of. We've accounted for all of our fixed appliances. Now in Article 220.53, it says pretty plainly that if you have four or more fixed appliances, you can apply a 75% demand factor to your calculation. We have five appliances, so we get to take advantage of that. And again, the more loads you have, the less chance you have of simultaneous operation. So what we have to do is come up with a total for these numbers here. So take our trusty calculator, 1300 for the dishwasher plus 1300 for the disposer plus 900 for the compactor plus 6000 for the water heater, and then finally plus 1500 for that blower motor. The total on that comes to 11,000 volt amps even. So I'm going to take that number and put it down here on the total line. And like we said, because we have five or more, we get to apply this demand factor. So pretty simple. Take your 11,000, multiply it by 0.75, and comes out to 8,250. That's going to get entered here. And we're done with the second part of the standard calculation. We still, though, have to transfer that number over to these running tally columns. Our goal is to have all six of these values in the six different portions added together, and that will be the answer to a standard calculation. So I'm just going to write those in here. For the phase conductor and also for the neutral. So now we've done part one, which is the general lighting load up here, and we've done part two, fixed appliances.